Today is Tuesday, December 20th, 2022, back for another daily review. And guys, today I actually saw some decent price action, even though it looks a little choppy on the 1 hour chart. But there was some good opportunities today and I was able to get involved, even though I wasn't expecting to. Did have some time in the morning, so I did catch a couple trades. Took a loss and two wins, one small, one normal size win. And I'll get to those in just a minute. And then if there's time at the end of the video, there is a Forex example that I want to take a look at and go over. So stick around for that. And let's get into the NASDAQ recap. Today we can see that we've been in this downtrend. I was looking earlier at the end of the day yesterday, hoping for a retracement back up into the, you can see this 1 hour imbalance. It's also a 4 hour and a daily volume imbalance. And you can see also the weekly open I've added to the chart. So maybe that's an area we can see get hit later in the week. But for now, we can see that heading into the market around New York, we saw a sharp move down during Asia related to Bank of Japan news. All prices done since then has kind of ranged between this high and this low. But within that, there were some nice opportunities. And also using the DR, not just the DR, but the ODR. So the first trade I took, and again, I'm not used to trading before New York Stock Exchange open, but I am on the East Coast. Normally, I'm on the West Coast, and so I'm up 3 hours earlier than I would normally be, and I can't help myself. If I look at the chart and I see a setup, I want to take it, and this was a very clean scenario four where we have our ODR, so we have this low and this high. We do have a confirmed break above, suggesting that we're not going to see this low get hit. And it doesn't get hit, it gets hit in the next session. So for the remainder of this session, it did not actually get hit, but we still had a very good, in my opinion, scenario four. And if I jump out to the 4 hour chart, I can bring you, see clearly we're in a downtrend, and I can mark out this up close candle, which is this order block level and price. So if we remember what a scenario four is, it's a break of the DR high and then a reclaim after hitting a higher time frame point of interest like this order block. Also have some imbalance down here. If you look at the 15 minute, or the 1 hour, as I showed you before, this is part of that big news release out of Japan that led to this move. So price came back up, filled some of it in, hit the 4 hour order block, reclaimed, and then for a while, there was really nothing of interest here, no real setup. But then once we got into New York kill zone, like which is normally the kill zone for Forex, so felt like it was an okay time. We got this displacement here. So again, reclaim, took out this low, short-term low right here, left this gap. And this was where I got involved. And so there's two setups here. One was to the midpoint, which it almost hit. And then once it started pushing back up, I just closed the trade because maybe I shouldn't have, clearly, because it did go a little bit further eventually. But again, I'm not so comfortable trading at this time. But I did see that 5 minute imbalance turn into a 15 minute imbalance. And so I wanted to re-enter after taking out this low. So again, same kind of premise, but hitting the order block, taking out a short-term low, creating this imbalance. That was the next entry that I took. Stop above here. I think I was targeting here. Now I didn't even, this was the first kind of small, these were the small wins I took. And essentially once we got right before New York Stock Exchange open, which was this candle right here, right before that, I think we were kind of close to this low again. I just didn't want to risk the volatility of the open. And so I think it was about 1R or so, a little over that, 1.5. I closed the rest of the trade here, even though it, you know, if I had held it, it would have been a winner, but I just didn't see the value in holding at this New York Stock Exchange open. I'd already taken that first small win here and then another small win here. So that added up to like a pretty decent start to the day. And then what we got at the New York Stock Exchange open, clearly we had a rate of this low and then an aggressive move higher, which formed our new DR range. And now the loss I took was, again, looking at this 4 hour order block, which I will extend out further into time. We then had a rate of this high, which was kind of the high made from London. So I saw that as a buy side liquidity grab and wicked into the imbalance higher up here. And then I saw on the 1 minute, this short-term low taken out with this imbalance right here. So this did not have DR confluence for this trade, as the DR hadn't formed yet, but I think it was like something like that I was targeting. And clearly I got stopped out of this. Totally fine with that. I would take that trade every time. Thought it was nice. And then eventually just kind of had to stay patient and got the same setup, even a better setup a little bit later. And at this point, price had taken out the high of day. So let's mark that as the high of day. So this was the high of day up to this point. This was the move prior to that dump in Asia. Price comes up, takes that high, and we get another scenario four right here. Price breaks above. Now at this point, I get clean up the chart a bit. At this point, I didn't know, you know, price was all the way up here at one point, and it looked very, very strong. And even though I preferred shorts, I was still marking out this swing low as a potential scenario three to maybe buy from. But my preference was shorts for what I mentioned on the higher time frame. Clearly, we've been bearish, the momentum is bearish, and we've hit a higher time frame point of interest. And so here, if we go down to my entry, again, this is the YouTube model, price makes a run above this high of day. This could have been an entry after this low. I wanted to see a little bit more. Price came down, broke this low and this low, leaving this imbalance. And that was my entry right off of that gap. Stop goes above here. And I think I just targeted, it was like 3.5 or something, maybe 3.3. It was like, I did this on my phone, so I think it was here. Yeah. It was like somewhere between 3 and 3.5 R. And I felt good with that. More than made up for this loss, and was a solid solid profit. Now I was also keeping an eye though on this swing low. As I said, technically this could have been a scenario three buy, as we had confirmed bullish, meaning that this low is unlikely to get hit, and it never did the rest of the day. But if we had gotten like a balanced price range, if price had probed down and then shot back up, leaving overlapping fair value gaps, or if we had gotten, let's say, such a move such as this, where it makes a low, this high comes down, and then shoots up with an imbalance, I would have definitely exited my short, or I would have definitely reduced the risk to slightly in profit or break even, because this would have been a valid scenario three. I don't think I necessarily would have felt comfortable buying it, but I probably would have managed the short differently if I had seen that. But nothing to worry about. Price just kind of reacted to it, filled in this gap that got created on the down move, and then rejected it, and then sold off and hit the take profit level. And look how my entry on the 1 minute aligns exactly with the break and reclaim of the DR. So we have this perfect tap of the IDR high after it broke back below. Also, this took out a swing low here as well on the 5 minute. And yeah, so I was very happy with that. So looking ahead on the daily chart, we reacted off of this down close candle, created a nice little pin bar candle, nice long wick. And so would I be surprised if we see some expansion bullish to the upside tomorrow? No, I wouldn't be surprised. And it wouldn't make me incredibly bullish unless we got a solid close back above the weekly open. So I think there could be a point in time tomorrow where, you know, the candle looks something like this. You know, we're get rid of that. Where, you know, one point in time, the we might have a bullish bar that looks like this, but you have to remember that that could still close with a long wick. It could still close like that with a long wick at the top. So I'm not necessarily going to be put off to shorting if the daily candle looks like this. Now, if we get very strong lower time frame bullish price action, then I'm not going to force a short either. I will be fluid and open to price reversing from here. But, you know, as I've said previously, my preference is to kind of go with the recent momentum. And then if we get an overwhelming sign of reversal, then so be it. So that's kind of what I'm looking at for tomorrow. And like I said, I'll take a look at Aussie dollar, because I thought there was a nice scenario too today. And just off the bat, just starting at the daily chart, we've been bullish, formed this kind of consolidation for several weeks. And then prices come down and hit multiple swing lows. And clearly we got a nice reaction to those lows. But what could have been a trade? Again, I wouldn't have really traded this because it does look a little messy, but I made it a point to study some Forex pairs, and I wanted to bring this up because we have bearish structure. We formed this low here. Price came up, made this high, made a lower low. Price then made a lower high. Price attempted to make a lower low. And then instead of making a lower low, had this strong rejection and then a continuation higher, leaving this bullish fair value gap. So once again, price is bearish, but it hits these daily sell side liquidity areas, reacts, has one bounce, and then that bearishness resumes, but it does not make a lower low. Does not make a lower low, shows rejection to the upside with an imbalance. So to me, that could be a solid framework for a short-term buy. Now, do we have a DR scenario to add on to that? And I would say yes. Here we have, again, this is the 1 hour fair value gap. We have confirmed break, so suggesting that we're not going to see a close below this low the rest of the day. And then if we go out to the 15 minutes, so what's a scenario two? Scenario two, look, we have the 15 minute order block as well as a 1 hour fair value gap after hitting sell side liquidity. Scenario two is a run below the DR low, premium discount, rejection of the low into a higher time frame PD array. So here we have also 5 minute, we have that 15 minute order block, 5 minute fair value gap, 15 minute order block, 1 hour fair value gap after hitting the sell side liquidity. So I just keep repeating myself, but it just helps to kind of stack these confluences up one by one. And then price kind of consolidates in between the IDR low and the DR low, never getting the close below. And then once you get a rejection, this could have been an entry with the stop a few pips below the DR, targeting the mid-range, targeting this high, targeting the IDR high, targeting the DR high, targeting high of day. And, you know, let's just target the IDR high, more conservative, could have gotten a very nice 3-hour trade. Took a while to play out, but again, it was just a nice example of how, even though we have pretty messy, choppy price action, you can still build a framework to be a buyer down here. So this is basically the retirement setup where you get a confirmation on one side and then a deep retrace. And then this is where you can get your best risk to reward trade. So this is something I'm going to continue to study more of in the future. And I might release a more comprehensive video about that retirement setup, but I just wanted to show it off today on Aussie dollar. Again, I didn't trade this, but I thought it was a good piece of price action to study. So that's it for tonight, and I hope everyone had a good day, and good luck the rest of the week.